Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. We are going to have our biology form 2, lesson 1, whereby your teacher will be Mr. Gerard. And our topic today will be on transport in plants and animals, whereby in the subtopic we are just going to introduce the transport in plants. So we are going to start with the introduction of transport in plants. We are going to have the following lesson called whereby by the end of the lesson we should be able to define transport and explain its necessity in plants and animals. On the introduction part of the transport in plants, we know that living organisms require nutrients and oxygen for the various metabolic activities taking place in their bodies. Nutrients and oxygen must be transported to all the living cells of the body. Metabolic activities release byproducts such as carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste that must be removed the moment they are formed. Otherwise, if allowed to accumulate, they may poison the cells. A means of transport is essential for the organism to carry the required substance to various parts of the body and remove the waste product from these parts. Unless you are aware that living organisms such as bacteria and simple multicellular organisms have small bodies that make them to have a large surface area to volume ratio. As a result of this, most of their body surface is in contact with materials in the environment. Therefore, dilution alone is enough to transport substances across their cell membranes and within the cells of the organism. In our organism, the surface area to volume ratio is small due to their large body size. Hence, the tissues and organs are far removed from the site of survival materials. In order for the deep-seated tissues and organs to obtain adequate supply of materials and at the same time have rapid waste elimination, an elaborate transport system is essential. This will transport substances closer to the tissue from where dilution can take place efficiently. Now we want us to define what transport is hereby. Transport is the movement of substances from one part of the body of an organism to another. It involves the movement of materials from the environment to the site where they are required and the removal of metabolic waste from their site of production to the site of elimination. In plants, certain metabolic waste are converted into less toxic substances and are transported to certain plant organs for storage. Now we are going to deal with the internal structure of the root, as we are aware that the root is is the start of the transport. As you know that the root is the one that is responsible for the absorption of water and mineral salts. In our diagram there you can see the cross-section of our root, whereby we have got several structures. First structure you can see we have the epidermis, we have also the cortex, we have the pericycle, and also the endodermis. We also have the vascular tissues, which is a combination of the xylem and the phloem, and as you are aware that the function of the xylem is to transport water while the transport food. We have got also the cortex and the pericycle and the dermis. The three of them, they form the ground tissue. Now we are going to look at a deep explanation of the root, whereby we can define a root as the part of a plant which is embedded in the soil, whose main function are. We're going to have around two functions of the root, whereby the first function of the root you can see is anchorage, whereby in anchorage we say it is holding the plant firmly in the soil. The second function of the root is for absorption, uptake of mineral ions and water. Other functions performed by certain specialized roots are storage, as in sweet potatoes, and gaseous exchange in mangrove forests. Now we are going to have at least we see the function of each part as we are seeing from our diagram. For example, we have the first part there is the cortex. Whereby we can say the cortex is made up of loosely packed thin-walled parenchyma cells. In young roots, it forms the extensive region between the epidermis and the vascular bundle. Water molecules pass through the deep tissues to reach the vascular bundle. It also acts as storage tissue. We have our second tissue there, which is the pericycle, whereby actually, the pericycle is a single layer of cells immediately before the endodermis that give rise to the lateral roots. As you can see from our diagram, we also have the endodermis, whereby endo means in, that is interior. So the endodermis is a single layer of cells surrounding the vascular bundles. It is characterized by possession of one starch grains that stain blue black with iodine solution. This is because as you are aware that when we test for the presence of starch, we use iodine, whereby if the results are positive, the color turns to blue black. The second characteristic of the endodermis is that the Kasparian strip, which has an impervious deposit on the radio and cross walls, the endodermis controls the amount of water and mineral salts entering the vascular bundles. We have now the vascular bundles, which as you can see, it is a combination of the xylem and the phloem tissue. You can see in both monocotyledonous and the dicotyledonous root, the vascular bundles, they occupy the central position. Each vascular bundle consists of the xylem and the phloem. In monocotyledonous roots, the xylem alternates with the phloem. On the other hand, in dicotyledonous roots, the xylem is star-shaped and the phloem is located between the arms of the stem. And as you can see from the periphery of the internal structure of the root, we have got some structures which resemble the root hairs. These ones are referred to as the root hairs, whereby they are microscopic. It will be difficult for you to see them using your naked eye, so it will be advisable you use the microscope in order for you to observe them. Their main function is literally to absorb water and mineral salts from the soil. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity whereby you are required to draw and label the internal structure of the root and give function of which part, as we have seen in our lesson. For more information, you can refer to KAB Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for more information about these lessons and more others, you can contact us by sending us an SMS to the number that you can see from the screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you subscribe to our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you send us a message on Twitter at Elimu_Kenya. Thank you for watching, and let us subscribe to have more and more lessons. Thank you.